we have Mr. J.K. Rajagopal, who is a second generation entrepreneur leading the legacy of his Padma Shri father, Dr. J.R. Krishnamurti, engaged in research-based herbal medicines company, Dr. J.R.K.'s Research and Pharmaceuticals Private Limited.
Mr. Rajagopal, you know, you have been talking about a lot of Siddha-based remedies, especially for COVID, and you said that is basically for combating any sort of unknown diseases. So I also bought, incidentally, your Kaba Sura Kuddineer online, and I distributed almost a lot of it to a lot of people, including all my watchmen and all the service guys, drivers, everybody. So because I said, let us all build on immunity. So Dr. Rajagopal, I mean, Mr. Rajagopal, what is it that you feel about this?
Yeah, thanks a lot, Mr. Vinod, and thanks a lot, SME, for this wonderful event. And I must also thank the Honorable of Deputy Secretary from Ministry. So that's a great way to acknowledge the system. I just wanted to recall that we in India are actually talking about Ayush. You know, Ayush is the ministry, and in Ayush, we start with Ayurveda, Yoga, Yunani, Siddha, and Homeopathy. That's a very, very vast and wonderful range of systems of medicine traversing across the various parts of India. So we are, our company, Dr. JRK's Research and Pharmaceuticals, we have actually worked on building the research platform for Siddha medicine. Siddha is a system of medicine which is originated in Tamil Nadu. With our humble little efforts, we have taken this system across the country and also to the rest of the world. Coming to your question, which is of course very relevant, that we are all working against the unknown aspect of the COVID, which slowly is getting unraveled. But as I'm very happy that you have taken up this Kaba Sura Kuddineer Churnam, which has been a drug, a classical drug for many years, but it was identified as having properties which can take care of both the symptomatic aspect of COVID as well as the much needed immunity building. So this is one of the drug which is also has close to now as part of a regimen in the state of Tamil Nadu. The government has set up several Siddha treatment centers across the state, and it's been very successful and slowly getting rolled out. And we as JRK Research have played a small role in taking this product to people, people who are outside Tamil Nadu. And I'm also very proud to say that this has gone outside India as well.
Mr. Rajagopal, a lot of debate is going on about lack of pharmacological studies and clinical trials on ancient formulations. So what do you think the government needs to do to ease proof of efficacy of these formulations and the battle of debates?
Yeah, I think it's a very, very important question that this panel as well as the entire industry needs to answer. I think we have harped on the fact that, you know, Ayush or Ayurveda, Siddha have been part of our country, and we expect people to take it on the face value and start using it. While that is definitely one way to communicate, the modern way is what Dr. JRK's research has always advocated, is you have everything proved out scientifically. So in our company, we have actually worked on three aspects. One is, first and foremost, everybody, including the normal people, are worried about the safety of the products. The first is the safety. Then how does it work? That is called as mechanism of action. And the last is, does it really work? You know, it's clinically efficacy. Clinical efficacy is proven. So we've always adopted, we have around 38 very well-researched products. So in all these products, I'm very proud to say that we have around 120, 130 published research papers in international journals of repute. And that's the very reason why, as Dr. Smita had talked of, our products have been registered as drugs, which is not very common. Usually they get registered as natural supplements. These products have been registered as drugs in many international places. Now, coming back to your thing, that I would not say that government should ease the restrictions on on these aspects. In fact, they should encourage pharmacological studies. They must encourage clinical studies. They must encourage safety studies. And it is a must for IUS system to have several thousand years ahead to have all these aspects demonstrated. Otherwise, we will always have a second pill or an also ran system. So what government should really do is to create an environment where all this can be done at a very cost-effective manner. We have done clinical trials, which is coming under the CTRI, clinical research establishment, where all the studies are registered. Believe me, to do a study of this, one needs to spend several, in today's context, several lakhs. And it costs does not come so easily for an MSME enterprise. You need to really put your bet on a product. And to even to do a clinical study, you need backworking of safety to give it to patients. You need to show them how it works. There are not many agencies which in India which can actually take up, because it's totally a gray black box to them. So we need to really starting them from the basics. There are not many good CROs, clinical research organizations in India, which can do it. So government must come forward to set up CROs, clinical research organizations, which take care of end-to-end product validation. We have gone through in a very hard way, and we have close to about 7 or 8 products which have done, where we have done CTRA registered studies to prove, only to prove. And that's the very reason why we have some of our products, most of our products being supported by leading allopathy doctors, because as Dr. Smita said, you need to talk to them in their language. You need to give it to them in their language, which I think that's how it can propagate going forward. So government, in my view, trying to water down the regulations will be not good in the long run. Government must actually continue to demand very strict. We must know how safe it is, and they are safe. Even one of our panelists said about metallic preparations. We have metallic preparations, and we have established that they are safe. It's not metals which are present in pure metallic form. They are processed, they are converted into a compound which is free from the free ions. So if you do a heavy metal analysis of our products, you will not find traces of free metallic ions. So some of these misconceptions should be broken by a very structured way to do it. And government can really do a heavy metal analysis for lead, arsenic, all these kind of mercury, these kind of heavy metals. It costs a lot. So if you have to do it for every batch you manufacture in India, which is, I think, is important, you cannot ignore Indian population. Why should it be less effective for Indian population compared to global? We should not talk of any differentiation. So we should encourage establishments to do these safety studies, the bare minimum, and government must come either subsidize or have establishments which do it at a very nominal cost. Otherwise, organizations, as you rightly said, they will take shortcuts. We will have television ads which claim things which are unbelievable, and therefore for the general public, the system will always have come to with a question mark. We cannot be talking about grandmother's medicines anymore. This should be part of even the child's medicine. Enough of such way of promoting Ayurveda or Ayush. We should talk science, and that's the best way the system can move forward. The government must encourage pharmacological studies, must encourage clinical studies, and there should be more avenues for industrial enterprises. There are CRIs, Central Research Institutes, available, but unfortunately, with due regards to them, they have not touched the lives of the common man yet. Even Mr. Vinod, you talked of Kabasara Kudineer. As we speak today, we don't have a single published paper from the government establishments to really give that confidence. And half of Tamil Nadu's population has taken that drink.
Taken, yes, right? Very correct.
And we have around 8,000 to 10,000 patients who have got treated with the management of Kabasara Kudineer, and still late we don't have a published research publication, which is not very difficult for a government to initiate and drive it through. So, Ministry of Ayush is actually very powerful, and they have a very good team, and the secretary is very dynamic. I'm sure they are already taking. So my bottom line to Ms. Sushmita's question, government should not water down. Government must encourage, must set up CROs and testing itself.
What is the future of Ayush? And what do you feel is a way forward or the business opportunity and advice that you have for our viewers today?
See, we see that Ayush products have got huge, we've been talking about immunity. There are a lot of diseases which are still for which there is no line of treatment available globally. For example, many autoimmune disorders. Our company has pioneered the treatment of product problems like psoriasis. It's a major global skin disorder affecting more than 2% of our population. Our single herb product, Dr. JRK's 777 oil, has been a kind of a gold standard. We're still doing a lot of research, and this product has been registered in many countries abroad. What I'm trying to say is there is a huge market which is there for problems like autoimmune disorders, for example, psoriasis, skin disorders, vitiligo, and then there are lifestyle disorders like diabetes for which still the world is grappling with effective solutions. So in terms of business opportunities, good, well-researched products in these categories have huge scope. We are working on an anti-diabetic, focusing on the comorbidities of diabetes. Because people, as Dr. Narum said, people don't want to eat with it. They want to see what extra, what is that thing which can come from the system. So look for products which have in this. The other thing is, which is a little more regulatory, it calls for a larger debate, but we have a lot of allopathy doctors who are willing to actively take up Ayush products, but unfortunately their hands are tied, and quite often we hear that, you know, yeah, I want to take up this product, but you know, there is an ICMR guideline already. I think there has to be a healthy debate on if some product is being found clinically effective, safe, and it has its proved mechanism of action. Medical practitioners, because we are talking about India, and India is the place where this system has originated, we must begin from home with a healthy support base. And whether we like it or not, allopathy system has got its tentacles across the country, which is good. They have established hospitals and things. This is the only platform through which Ayush system can also coexist. So more and more medical establishments which are meant for the larger public must have Ayush you know, sections. It is there, but it's still a very small percentage. And other government establishments like the Central Government Health Scheme, you know, today there are still very limited dispensaries across the country. And within that, if I have to take our example, Siddha Medicines, we hardly have about 4 or 5 clinics, whereas the products are in demand. The government must, in its own way, it's a lot of things is being done by the Ayush Ministry, but I think there are other departments of the government, including MSME, which can focus on helping MSME entrepreneurs enter the thing. There are a lot of entry restrictions which come in participating in large tenders. Sometimes you find the clauses are actually tailor-made for some companies. It's amazing. So they must encourage free participation of you know, business houses and small enterprises in government health program. Lastly, of course, I feel somewhere from the academic side, there must be an openness in creating an integrated medical system. Dr. Saurabh mentioned about the system of education. I'm taking that example of my father, Dr. Padmashri, Dr. J.R. Krishnamurti, who is actually qualified as GCIM, Graduate in College of Integrated Medicine, which is an equivalent of MBBS in the past. I feel somewhere this system made him understand the science as well as the tradition, and therefore come out with a better way of presenting things. Lastly, I will talk about innovation. Rishabh talked about it. Innovation has been also Dr. JRK's research for. We have come out with products in form which can be more acceptable to the general public. For example, preparing a quarter churnam or a kudini churnam involves boiling, filtering, and then cooling it down and taking it. Without compromising the principles of the Ayush, I think we have come out with ready-to-drink forms. So if medicines are, the drug deliveries are coming out in forms which have increasing public acceptance, because that's the way to go into their lifestyle. If everybody knows Ayush is good, you know, but, you know, I can't take this bitter pill, I can't do all this boiling, filtering, or I can't follow this lifestyle regimen, or, you know, get the raw herbs and mix your... Certainly, people, you cannot take away the fast lifestyle. For some time, we have been put on hold, but we are all going back to our fast lifestyle. People in Mumbai are going to jump into the trains. So we need to deliver drugs in a form which people can accept. So JRK's, we have done something. For example, we have introduced a pain relief product, which is a wash off. You use a pain relief during your taking bath. Action is a product name. So we always looked at innovation which can ensure drug delivery in a form which people can, in today's lifestyle, accept. We have to go into the lifestyle of people in the way which is... So I would look for entrepreneurs, look for innovative products, government to look at increasing presence of Ayush treatment centers in more locations, coexist with... I will also appeal to private hospitals. We have large corporate hospitals which are still predominantly driven by the modern system. I would look forward to every corporate of hospitals, you know, there are many, many, to please also look at having the Ayush as a very prominent, you know, presence. And I'm sure the doctors will, and the patients also will find a comprehensive value. Yeah, thank you.